So we are discussing the chapter options in derivatives, where we were discussing the option valuation models. One more model only is pending to be discussed, that is formula based, which is Black-Scholes model. Unlike the other models, we will not be having a very in-depth conceptual discussion. It is something like a formula application we are going to do. But significance of various terminologies which is used in the Black-Scholes formula, we will understand or discuss during the chapter called as Greeks, where we will be knowing the significance of certain computations made in the Black-Scholes formula. But at present, we will be discussing only the formula-based approach for the Black-Scholes model. Normally, for most of the issues, we derive the formula in the classroom. This alone, I do not understand the derivations, I could not discuss. It is having so many issues, that is, it cannot be communicated. That is why we just only go by the formula. That is how we discuss the sharp optimum portfolio. We had an elaborate formula discussed, same way we'll be having a big formula we'll be applying and doing the Black-Scholes model calculation. Once we complete the Black-Scholes model, today we'll also do the option valuation with dividends coming into the picture. Again, same story, minimum value, maximum value of call option, put call parity, Black-Scholes model, all this let me discuss once again when there is a dividend which is declared on the underlying asset. So this is the agenda for our today's class discussion. And one more concept pending in this option chapter is American options. All the issues will be rediscussed from the American option point of view, and then we'll move on to the chapter called as futures. Now let us summarize what has been discussed in the option till now before we proceed further. There are two types of option contracts, call option, put option. Call option gives its holder right to buy an underlying asset at an agreed price called as strike price on a particular date, which is a maturity date. And the person who is agreeing is called as a writer. He is having an obligation to sell to the holder of call option. For getting that right, the holder pays the writer a premium. Put option holder gets the right to sell underlying asset at an agreed strike price on the maturity date. Writer of a put option is having an obligation to buy. And in case of the put option also, the holder pays the writer the premium for getting that option. There are three types of share prices: spot price, future spot price, and strike price. The price at which the share is traded today is called as spot price. The price at which we agree to buy on the maturity date is called as strike price. FSP is the actual price prevailing on the maturity date. So the option will be exercised or lapsed based on the holder's preference. Holder will exercise a call option if the FSP is more than strike price. Holder of a put option will exercise the put option if the FSP is less than strike price. When the option is exercised, it is said to be in the money. Lapse means out of money, and indifferent means at the money. There are two types of options, American and then European option. American option gives its holder the right to buy or sell on the European option on the maturity date, American option on or before the maturity date. Then we saw what is a break-even FSP. It is a few maturity spot price at which the payoff for the holder and writer is zero. For call option, it is strike price plus premium. For put option, it is strike price minus premium. Then we discuss about option strategies, where we saw the long straddle, short straddle, long strangle, short strangle, bull spread with call option, bull spread with put option, bear spread with call option, bear spread with put option, butterfly spread are all the strategy which we have discussed. Then we started discussing about the option valuation models, and before that the valuation concepts. we had two small issues discussed, short selling and then continuous compounding. So short selling is where you sell the share first and buy it later. When you sell the share, you give the delivery to the buyer by borrowing the share and giving the delivery. Later buy the share and close your short position. In case of next continuous compounding, it is nothing but compounding done continuously, that is every day or every minute, etc., where the future value is equal to present value into e power tr, and e raised to x is equal to 1 plus x power 1 by 1 factorial plus x squared by 2 factorial plus x cube by 3 factorial and so on. Present value is equal to future value divided by e power tr, or future value into e power minus tr gives you the present value. Once we completed this, we discuss about the minimum and maximum value of call option. When I say option value, we are discussing about the premium. A call and put premium should not be below certain number, should never go above a certain number. It should not be below what? Minimum value of a call is spot price minus present value of strike price. Minimum value of a put is present value of strike price minus spot price. Maximum value of the call is spot price. Maximum value of the put is present value of strike price. If the actual value is below minimum, above maximum, what exists? Arbitrage exists. Call option value actually is trading below the minimum value, then call is underpriced or overpriced? Underpriced. What you should do? Buy the call option or hold the call option and then short sell the share. If it is trading above the maximum call option, underpriced or overpriced? Overpriced. What a strategy? That is, write the call option and then buy the share. If the put option is trading below the minimum, it is underpriced. What a strategy? Hold the put option and then buy the share. Above the maximum, what a strategy? Write the put option. Then we had discussed about put call parity, that is equation, where we saw that if the call and put is written on the same underlying asset, having the same maturity period, same exercise price, then the call price, put price, share price, the triangle should form a parity, called as put call parity. So the put call parity equation is VC plus PV of X is equal to VP plus VS. If the actual prices, if you put into the equation, the parity is absent. What is present? Arbitrage present. How to make a put call parity? Arbitrage. Also has been consequently discussed. Then we saw that we have been discussing only about the ranges and the satisfaction of parity, but we did not corner how to value an option. We wanted a model for valuing an option. How we have a share valuation model, we wanted to have an option valuation model. Different persons can have a different answer from that model based on input data they put into the model, but they should be having a standard way of valuing it. For that, we discussed there are four option valuation models: binomial, risk neutral, two period binomial, and Black-Scholes model. Binomial model is having how many steps? Six steps. The first, it assumes a portfolio. The portfolio, don't question, is a standard portfolio. What the portfolio? Write a call and hold delta shares. What is step one? Change in value of call and change in FSP. Step two is what? Delta shares. What delta shares? Change in VC divided by change in FSP. Step three is future value of portfolio. Step four is present value of portfolio. Step five is present value of delta shares. Step six is value of the call option. Put option value found out using the put call parity equation. Next, we discuss about the risk neutralization model. In risk neutralization model, we have only three steps. What are three steps? Risk neutral probability, future value of call and put, present value of call and put. Risk neutral probability can be found out in two ways: table approach, formula approach. What is the table? You have situation, FSP, probability, expected FSP. Equate the expected FSP to spot price compounded to future using risk-free rate. In that case, we are finding out the probability of upper FSP and downward FSP. Second step is expected value of call and put using the risk neutral probability. Step 3 is find out the present value discounting the risk-free, discounting using the risk-free rate. Further, we discussed the formula for calculating the probability. Risk neutral probability P is equal to e power PR of minus D divided by U minus D, where the P means what? Upper FSP is probability and downward FSP probability is 1 minus P. Once we completed this risk neutralization model, we discussed a two-period binomial model where we saw that in risk neutralization model, within the option period, only once it changes, that's a spot price, there can be an upper FSP or downward FSP. But two periods is that, suppose an option is a 6 months option, within 6 months it changes how many times? Two times. In that case, we'll be having how many possible FSPs on the maturity date? Four possible FSP. So by changes what? Three times, the possible FSP increases. So we just discussed about the two period binomial model. We did two problems. You all remember or not? Any number? No. And I also remember that for those two problems, I gave you two more sums as homework. What is that? For the call option, I ask you to do the put option. For the put, I ask you to do the call option. Did you all do it or not? Those who have done it, raise your hand. Okay. Did you all get the put call parity satisfied? Huh? One or two number decimals here and there, then you can just check out the rounding off. But it should satisfy the put call parity. Yeah. Others. Okay, first, did you all revise and come up? What has been discussed? Yes. Understand that. Risk neutral and all, we discuss very elaborately, in-depth, the logic, etc. Notes has been dictated, right? Now, all this you'll forget, that grip will be lost if we don't revise it. That chapter should be pakka before it gets completed. Please revise then and there. I already said. Can I proceed up? Now. Next model is what? Black-Scholes model. You can simply call it as a Black-Scholes calculator. They always call it as Black-Scholes calculator. Even books like Hull and all doesn't go more into the derivation of the Black-Scholes formula. They start their derivation itself only from a given level. Okay, so it is very intricate. Nobel has been given for this particular option valuation model called as Black-Scholes model. So it is they call it as Black-Scholes calculator because people rarely understand the concept behind the option valuation model. They use it as a calculator to find out the option value. Okay. When you use a calculator, you don't go behind the scenes and see how it is doing the calculation. Same way computer also, same way we just use the Black-Scholes model also. Okay. Now, but some really interesting aspects on this Black-Scholes calculation, like the numbers like ND1 we'll be using later. All this will be seeing the significance when you discuss a chapter called as Greeks. The Greeks chapter alone I discuss at the end of the batch because till now in the institute, it is not really in the syllabus, we can say. They had a mention about Greek letters, that's all. Like a delta, theta, gamma, rho, etc. But it has not been even given in RTPs or what in the problems. Okay, so I don't want to take the prime time now for the discussion of Greeks. We will discuss the Greeks as the last chapter in our syllabus once all the other chapters are completed, so that examination preparation will not get affected due to that particular discussion. Okay, now I think everybody can bring a bat here. Correct? Yes, sir. Yanaki or bat tevaya? Can I ever say now? Stop. Now let us start discussing about the Black-Scholes model. Okay, see. Before I start with the Black-Scholes model, let us understand what factors influences the option value. That is a very important discussion, which is also tested in exams, in theory part. So what factors affect the option values? All these factors are conserved by Black-Scholes model. That is the important thing. Okay. Call option premium is there. Put option premium is there. What affects premium? What are all the input factors that is going to affect the premium of a call option or put option? How it gets affected is the issue. Can we start or not? Now. See. The following factors are the following five factors affects the option value. They are A, spot price of the underlying asset has an important role in option valuation. B is X. X means what? Strike price. And C is the interest rate. The prevailing interest rate in the markets, the LIBOR rate, or it may be a prime lending rate, the government interest rate or the bank interest rate prevailing in the market. Normally we call this as risk-free rate. Can anybody say? Now, D is the term of the option and E is the volatility. Volatility is measured by standard deviation. Always the word volatility means variation. Variance is called as what? Standard deviation. People know how to calculate standard deviation for the share prices. We know statistically the calculation of the standard deviation. So all these five factors are going to affect the option values. Okay. So a premium for an option is influenced by how many factors? Five factors. What are the five factors? Spot price, strike price, interest rate, term, and then volatility. Can I push it or not? No. I'll discuss and then dictate the notes in this regard. Very simple and easy discussion only. Let's take item by item and see how it gets affected, how the value gets affected through these items. Okay, now the first item is what? Spot price of the asset. Okay, please. We have call option and then what? Put option. Okay. Asset spot price can be low. Asset spot price can be what? High. A share which is trading at a lesser price, a share which is trading at what? Higher price. Okay. Spot price of asset can be low as well as what? High. Okay. Now, for understanding the impact, we'll use the formula which only Black-Scholes elaborates. Okay. Call option value is spot price minus present value of strike price. This only we call as minimum value. So no, I always said maximum is only a academic. No fool will just say trade at what? Such a high price and all. Normally the word value, na, the most logical formula is a minimum value formula only. This formula is much more fine-tuned by the Black-Scholes model calculation later. Okay. So what is the value of the call? Spot price minus present value of strike price. I forgot. What is the value of the put option? Present value of strike price minus spot price. Everybody following or not? Now, just to once again know the logic of this formula, simple logic. See, call option holder will buy at strike price and sell at spot price. Kadva? Will buy at strike price, sell at what? Spot price. Two ways of understanding it. Now, he is going to buy at strike price when? Suppose 6 months option. After how many months here? 6 months. He is going to pay X. After how many months here? 6 months. If the FSP is more than X, kadava? Now, imagine like this. After 6 months, he is going to exercise the option and pay what? The strike price and sell it to what? FSP. Always you buy an option to exercise, not to lapse. Kadava? So, the value is paid not to last. Value is paid only to what? Exercise. So, you are a call option holder. What is the value you get after 6 months? FSP minus X. Yes or no? The value after 6 months, what you get is what? FSP minus 6. For that only you pay a price today. Yes or no? Value of the option is the present value of the future benefit. Yes or no? So the future benefit what you get is FSP minus X. And for the present value is what? The premium which I pay. Yes or no? Now, let's independently see what a future benefit. FSP minus X. I'll just write it. FSP minus X. For this, I have to calculate present value or not. What is the present value of FSP? Spot price. What is the present value of strike price? PV of X. So I can say the value of the call is what? Spot price minus PV of X. The other way to do it is a riskless strategy. I said, what I can do? I can short sell the share today at what price? Spot price. I can buy the share tomorrow at what price? Strike price. And close my short position. Yes or no? But the spot price minus strike price cannot be netted off because this is today and that is what? Tomorrow. Here the spot price minus what? Present value of strike price. To put it simply, call option, the share market price is a selling price. In call option, the share market price is what? Selling price. The agreed price is purchase price. Right or not? There's opposite for put option. Put option, the agreed price is what? Selling price, right? To sell at what price? Strike price. And the share market price for asset is what? The purchase price. In the paritana. That's what I'm saying. So, see, the share underlying asset has got two prices. How many prices here? Two prices. One in the share market, another in what? The option market agreed price. Now, so the option market agreed price we call as what? Strike price. The share market price we call as what? FSP. Whose present value is what? The spot price. Any opinion? Do you understand this or not? In that case, now tell me, call option. In case of call option, share market price is what price? What price? Yeah, selling price. It is what price? Selling price. Strike price is what? Purchase price. I have a right to buy a strike price. I will sell it what? The share market price. So no. And in case of put option, the strike price is what? Selling price. And the spot price is what? Purchase price. Is it clear? Now from this we can understand this very easily. Spot price is what for call option? What for call option is selling price. So one strategy is what? Short sell. I'm going to get a benefit from what? Selling the share. Short sell at what price? Spot price. If spot price is a selling price, tell me when the spot price is low, the call option value is higher or lower? Is it low? The call option value is what? Low. The call option value decreases. If the spot price is low, the call option value decreases. Enna paisa no na. And spot price is high, the call option value what? Increases. Because another simple way of understanding is, I get a right to buy a diamond. I get a right to buy what? Diamond. Another person get a right to buy a slipper. Which is having more premium? Diamond right or slipper right? Tell me. Obviously, because the value of the asset is more, the option is what? More attractive. Right? What I am saying? So that's a very crude example, but still, but what I explained earlier is what? Much more apt. So spot price for a call option is what? Selling price. Spot price is what? Selling price. Strike price is what? Purchase price. Put option spot price is what? Purchase price. Strike price is what? Selling price. Is logical simple. I get a right to sell put option at what price? Strike price. I buy at what? Open market at spot price. Call option, I get a right to buy at what? Strike price. I sell open market at what? Spot price. Yes or no? Now, so call option value we discuss. Now, at least don't look at this. Without looking at this, tell me put option. I just covered it. Put option. The spot price of the share is low. What put option price? The put option price is going to be what? High. Because I have a low purchase price, I have a high strike price. It's going to be what? High. Next is, the spot price is high. What a put option value? Low. So that is how the spot price influences what the option. Are you following what I am saying now? Like that. Next, item number B is what? Strike price. Okay, once again, what are two options? Call option, put option. Strike price can be high, strike price can be low. Call option gives a holder right to buy at what? Strike price. If I give a right to buy at high strike price, attractive caller, less attractive caller, less attractive caller. If I give a right to buy at a high strike price, that's not a great right. Yes or no? In that case, the value of the call what? Reduces. I give a right to buy at a low strike price, it becomes what? Attractive. Then the value what? Increases. We already discussed in the spreads. Now, put option value, I give a right to sell at a high strike price. I give a high guaranteed selling price. What is it? That is the put what? Increases. I give a low guaranteed selling price. The put option value what? Decreases. That is how the call and put option values get affected by what? Strike price. So spot price also affects the call and put. Strike price also affects what? The call and put in opposite way. Everybody following or not? Like a client is there. Now the third is what? Third is interest rate. Third is what? Interest rate. Once again, what? Call option and then put option. Interest rate is high. Interest rate is what? Low. See. Present value of strike price will become smaller or bigger when discount higher rate, smaller. More the discount rate, lesser the present value. So the present value reduces, then the value of the call what? Increases. In a spot price minus present value of strike price. In other words, very simple, I have to pay the strike price only after 6 months. If the interest rate is very high, the strike price become more attractive because till that time I enjoy interest in my hand. Yes or no? If I have to pay today, I will be losing interest on that. Yes or no? If I have to pay after what? 6 months. Till that time I am enjoying a float. Yes or no? In that case, I have a right to buy only on the later date. Call option outflow occurs tomorrow. When the outflow occurs tomorrow, I am very happy the interest rate is what? Very high, because till the outflow is made, I can enjoy the interest on the strike price. In other words, when I short sell the share, I will deposit the money to pay the strike price. Yes or no? In that case, I deposit the money at what rate? High interest rate. I'll be able to earn more value for the call. Everybody follow what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
It's going to be opposite for what? Put option. Put option, what happens is, I'm going to sell tomorrow. I'm going to sell what? Tomorrow. I postpone my collection. That means what? If the interest rate is high, I'll lose lot of time value of money. Right or not? In other words, I have to buy the share today. I have to want to buy the share today and sell the share tomorrow. So no, when I buy the share today, I have to invest a lot of money in that or not? Because the loan amount is more. The interest rate is higher. So interest rate more, now put option is adversely affected. Call option is what? Favorably affected. Is the impact of interest rate on call option. Enna purinjadha? Everybody yes or no? No. So tell me, what is the interest rate's impact? Call option, high interest rate means call option value is what? Higher. Because I pay later, interest rate is to my advantage. And put option is having what value? Low value. Interest rate low, call option value is low. Put option value is what? High. This is regarding the interest rate impact on call option and put option. Please tell me yes or no? No. How the interest rate affects, the same way the term also affects, because longer the term, more the value of the call. Yes or no?
Yes,
I give you a right to join SFM class after 3 years at the same fees. Then what happens here? Is it attractive, right? Less attractive. It is attractive, yeah, because after 3 years the fees will be much more higher, right or not? No. But I give a right to join the SFM class tomorrow, the same fees. What happens here? It is not at all a right. Are you following what I am saying? In that case, see, when I give you a guaranteed purchase price, which is going to happen after what? Long period. Then the purchase price gains more value because I am going to have lot of time value of money inside the purchase price. In that part, right? What I am saying? So, longer the term, the PV of X becomes what? Smaller. Discounting 6 months and discounting 6 years, which is a small number, 6 years discounting only. So that is what is advantage of the call option. When the term is longer, the call option value increases. When the term is shorter, the call option value decreases. Opposite for put option, because put option gives you a right to sell after what? Long period. Till then the money is not with me, the money is blocked with the other party for a long period of time. Yes or no? In that case, the put option value increases as a period decreases, decreases as a period increases. Increases. Everybody able to understand that?
Yes,
and bhayam irukka, are you listening or not? No. Tell me next point D or E?
D.
Point D. Okay. A, B, C only over here. Yeah? Next is what? D. D is what? Term of the option, call option, put option. Term is long. High means what? Long term option. Okay. Term is long. Now, don't by heart tell me. Long term option. Now, call option has got what value? High value. Put option is having low value. And then the term is what? Short. What the call option value? Low. Put option value is what? High. And last is what? Volatile. Till now, we have seen that. For any factor, call option value high, na, put option value is what? Low. Call low means what? Put option value high. You are seeing this for spot price, strike price, interest rate, as well as what? Term. The last is what? Volatility. Volatility means how volatile is the share price. Now, I ask you a question. I give you an option on Government of India bond. Today, Government of India bond is trading at 1000 rupees. Okay, I give you a right to buy the bond after 6 months at 1000 rupees. Will you pay premium? I know you're also going to be that day also at what? 1000 only, will not change. Are you following what I'm saying? See, when I give a Government of India bond an option, call option, the bond value may small change may be there due to ITM, but not what very much. That call or put, both are not attractive because we know certain, only when something is uncertain, I give an option. Yes,
sir.
Simple, yeah? Now, I'll just give a simple example. Now, in examination, I given a list of important questions. Again, you want list of important questions. From that only question will come. For example, okay, I am not setting question paper and done. Okay. I give only a list of important questions. So I give you around 15 questions. Example, what is the question? What I am saying? I give how many questions? 15 important questions. Prepare from this. From this only what? It comes. Okay. For that question paper, I'll give you a choice. I give you what? A choice. Is the choice worth or not worth? Not worth, because you already know the question, yeah. Why choice? Every question can be prepared and written, yes or no? Now, suppose question paper is not known to you, anything may be asked. Okay, in a SMM question paper, even biology question can be what? Asked. For example, open ended. Okay, now, for example, okay, now, you don't know the question paper, very uncertain. In such a question paper, is choice attractive or not? Yes. A very difficult question paper where a lot of uncertainties are involved, then it will be very much appreciating for what? Choice. Option is nothing but what? Choice. For a share which is not volatile, less volatile, there is no charm in having what? Option for the share. The reason is what? It is having a certain price within a range. In that case, the option will not be what? Attractive. There's a share who price jumps up and down in so much variability. You can touch 3000 rupees, drop to what? 800 rupees. Can just go up and down, very volatile. In case of volatile market only, what becomes attractive? Option. It may be call option or put option becomes attractive only when the underlying asset value is what? Very volatile. If it is less volatile, I don't have an attraction towards what? The option. Now, I'll give you a technical way of understanding it also. Okay, see. I have a strike price. I want a strike price. Okay, now, share price can go what? Up and down. Okay, this is an option period, can go up and down. Please. See, understand that strike price, you are a holder of the call option. Now, when the share is very volatile, when it touches here, you have a lot of profit to be made. Because if the share is very volatile, we have seen in the past trend that can even touch this particular number. In that case, you see the number and say, see, when I hold this option, I have a chance, I have what? Chance to earn so much FSP minus what? Strike price. I like this option, yes or no? Yes. You may ask, sir, don't say like this. He can touch as high as this, also can touch what? As low as this. If he can make so much profit, wouldn't he make what? So much loss? No, because when it crosses below the strike price, he allow it to lapse, yes or no? Option holder is not at all worried about the unfavorable movement. He is always seeing only what? Favorable movement. The reason is, unfavorable, he need not suffer loss. He allow it to lapse. Yes or no? Can you understand? Now, if in case of the normal share, more the volatility, the share is less worth. The share is what? Less worth, because more risk, more the discount, less the value of the share. Yes or no? Because there the party is exposed to upper swing as well as what? Down swing. In case of an option holder, suppose you are a call option holder, if the share is very volatile, the share is what? Very volatile. I like to buy that option. I like to buy that option because it always gives me a scope to make a bumper profit. I don't have a risk of making a huge loss because I'll never make a loss since I have an option to what? Lapse the option. Same way I can say it for what? Same share can even attract what? Put option person also, because the share can touch rock bottom also. Yes or no? In that case, you can sell a strike price or share worth what? So low. Don't worry, sir. Whatever share price ties to what? The upper say, limit. He need not worry because he can allow it to lapse. Yes or no? That means, if a share is very volatile, if the share is what? Very volatile, that share's option should be more attractive. Should be what? More attractive. If the share is what? Less volatile, then the option should be what? Less attractive. Any approach? Are you following what I'm saying? Now, always uncertainty more. Now, option becomes what? More attractive. Very simple. Life insurance premium. Let us say what? Life insurance premium. Same way, if the rider is made to cover a high volatile stock, he is taking higher risk. Yes or no? If the rider is made to cover what? A low volatile stock, he is taking what? A low risk. If he takes a high risk to cover your risk, you have to charge what? More premium. If he's exposed to low risk, he'll be charging only what? Less premium. These are how the volatility affects the options. Now, these 5 points I said, no? All these 5 points only will be discussed in what? Greeks later. How the spot price change, how the strike price change, how sensitive is what? Option value to all the five. More elaborately using Black-Scholes, we'll be discussing an area called as what? Greeks later. Everybody following or not? Now, so now tell me the last item, volatility. I want you to tell me the answer. Call and then what? Put option. Volatility high, volatility low. High volatility, call option value.
High.
Put option value.
High.
Low volatility.
Low.
Put option value.
Low.
Here only both have the same trend. So no, all others going to act the opposite. Volatility alone, both options are what? Same. Okay. Now, if you have seen all the problems, we calculate the option values. Generally, put option value is lower than call option. Put option value is always what? Lower than call option. The reason is the volatility can go up to infinity. But here, there is also a, it cannot go below what? Zero. And mostly also, if you see, the options are designed in such a way that if you look at the share market, overall, the market shows only a rising trend. Anyway, if we compare 1960 and today, has the share price has fallen? The share price may fluctuate, but overall, anywhere, the increase is generally more than what decrease. You know, people always expect positively the market to behave, yes or no? So always, the option which provides for an increased coverage is more attractive than what? An option that provides for what? A bear. Bullish trend is more likely compared to what a bearish trend in the economy. Are you following what I am saying? In that case, that is why generally, if you see all the models, they put more value for what? Call option and less value for a put option. Everybody, are you following or not? Now, with this, we have completed the 5 factors that affects the option valuation. We will elaborate all this further in the chapter called as Greeks later. Okay, now, tell me what are the 5 factors affecting the option value: spot price, strike price, term, and then the say volatility. Now, all of you, without looking at it, tell me spot price more. You tell me for call. Put, I'll allow you to understand on your own. Call option alone, tell me for all the 5. Spot price more. Call is what?
High.
Call value is what?
High.
Spot price less. Because I give a right to buy a very attractive high spot price asset. I give a right to buy what? A less attractive low spot price asset. Spot price high means call option value high. Low means what? Call option value low. Strike price is a purchase price for the call option or not? Tell me. High strike price, call is what?
Low.
Less attractive. Low strike price?
High.
Are you following what I am saying? Now, interest rate. More interest rate, call value?
High.
Less interest rate, call value?
Low.
Because more interest rate, that is less the present value of the payment and so on. Term more, call option value
more.
Term less, call option value
less.
Volatility more, call option value
high.
Volatility less, call option value low. So this is how the option values gets affected through the 5 factors. It is opposite for what? Put option, except for the last item called as volatility, where both are going to be equally good. Everybody following or not? Okay, now I have to give you notes for Hiller's model. Never come. Now I will be giving you in the short time because IPSC batch has got completed. Now I will type and I have to give notes for, I think, Hiller's model. And I should be giving you, I will give you the notes for this 5 factors also, because I don't want to dictate this. I think I understood or not. So we will be discussing this in Greeks also later. I will give you the printed notes for these 5 factors, what I discuss probably in the next class. I will be giving you the notes for both. Understood? And I think any other notes pending, a leasing problem solution. That you give me time, I have to type and solve. That's what I'm saying. So it is a very tedious process. I cannot delegate to any person. I'll give it to you, but don't ask me the time frame. Give me the option, like an American option. Can be accessed anytime before March 31st. Can I put it now? So I will have a right to exercise anytime. Don't put it as an European. Can I proceed it now? Please. These 2 I'll be giving you in the next class. Now, I am not dictating the notes for what I have discussed, no factors influencing the option. Just to save time, I'll give you in the printed form in the next class along with the Hiller's model notes. Okay, now please. From 2-period binomial only, it was extended to what? Black-Scholes. See, in binomial, we have a spot price, we have what? FSP 1 or what? FSP 2. This model can be used only when an underlying asset has got only two possible maturity prices. That too, it changes only once during the entire option period. In that case, only binomial can be implemented. Yes or no? So they just further expanded it in which spot price can become what? FSP and FSP. Yes or no? Now, this FSP can also become what? FSP 1, FSP 2. This can be FSP 3. This can become what? FSP 4. In that case, during option period, how many times the underlying asset value changes?
Two times.
So I'll be confronted with how many FSPs? Four FSPs on the maturity date. That's one. Yes or no? How it can change two times during the option period? Can even change three times. Can even change what? Three times. Can even change what? Four times. So more the frequency changes, it changes very rapidly. Yes or no? Now Black-Scholes change says that share price goes up and down every day. How many times? So many number of times. I just use the word infinite, but it is not infinite, but it's going to change what? So many number of times. Because every second if you see in the stock market screen, the share price keeps on what? Changing in paise or rupee amounts. Are you following what I'm saying? In that case, so Black-Scholes says that the option, the underlying asset price, like shares and all, will not change once, will be changing what? Many times during the option holding period, it changes infinitely. So this single period binomial tree or two period binomial tree becomes what? An infinite period binomial tree becomes what? An infinite period binomial tree where the branches of the binomial tree is what? Infinity. That is, I don't say it will touch infinite price up and what? Down. That is not what we are saying. That's a volatility range. That's what? They'll be having 10% up or what? 10% down. That's a volatility range. But within that range, I don't have four prices or what? Five prices. Within that range, I have what? Infinite prices possible. So I don't say it is between, it is 90 or 110. I come to a situation, it's going to be what? 90 to 110. Everybody, are you following what I'm saying? So the share price volatility, when it changes every time, it becomes an infinite period binomial tree. How to value that only we are going to use in the Black-Scholes model. Black-Scholes uses certain mathematical concepts. Okay, he used something called as log normal distribution. We have heard about normal distribution. Log normal distribution is used for those things where it cannot take a negative value, where a number cannot take a negative value. They use a log normal distribution. He used exponential because it's an infinite period. Always when I say limit tends to infinity, it becomes e calculation. Everybody follow in order. So when since we are using e only, we once again come back to the log normal distribution. Based on this, he goes for a model called as Black-Scholes model for option valuation. So here we're going to listen to the steps and then simply apply and do it. Examination regularly. Questions are asked from the Black-Scholes model. Very easy to answer because once you have by heart of the steps, we need not have any creativity in answering the question. Just apply the steps and answer the questions. Everybody, are you following or not? Now let's go for the Black-Scholes model. So nothing needs to be written. Everything has been only discussed now. Can I proceed? Now let's start with the Black-Scholes model for option valuation. See. Now, Black-Scholes model values call option and put option. Class validation is by hearting only, by heart in itself. Okay, values call option and put option using the following formulas. Please, value of call is equal to S into ND1 minus X into e power minus TRF into ND2. Okay, now. You need not worry about the buy harding. Very simple. Value of the call is spot price minus present value of strike price. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Isn't that correct? No. Only thing is, to the spot price, I multiply by what? ND1. And X into e power minus TRF is what? Present value of strike price. I multiply by what? ND2. What is this ND1, ND2 and all will be understanding during the Greeks later. Can I put it or not? So, what is the value of the call option? S into ND1 minus X into e power minus TRF into ND2 is the value of the call option. Yes or no? No. Can you guess what is the value of the put option? சொல்லுப்பா, x into e power minus tr of into n d2 minus s into n d1. Only small change, value put is x into e power minus tr of into n minus d2. N what? Minus d2. It's a reverse probability. N minus d2 minus s into n minus d1. That's going to be the value of the put option. That is how the Black-Scholes model values what? The call option and put option. Okay, now. Don't get irritated. Tell me what is the value of the call. VC is equal to S into ND1 minus X into e power minus PR into ND2. What is the value of the put option? X into e power minus PR into N minus D2 minus S into N minus D1. Is the value of the call and put. Yes or no? No. So to calculate all this, I'll be having 12 steps. How many steps here? 12 steps. So some steps are very smallest step, number only 12. Substantially only 2 steps are mainly involved here. Okay, how many steps are there here? 12 steps. Okay, now see. First step is ln of S by X. S means what? Spot price. S means spot price here. Don't say strike price. S means what? Spot price. X means what? Strike price. So, spot price by strike price you find out, see in a table called as natural log table. What table here? Natural log table. They'll be having a number. That is what you call as what? Ln of S by X. Okay, we'll see calculation later. What is step one? Ln of S by X. Ln means what? Natural log. Are you following what I'm saying? To the base E, they use this natural log calculation. Please, shh. Can I push it or not? No. Step two is to calculate D1. What is step two here? D1. That's a formula for calculating the D1. Leave it. We'll come back to that later. But step 2 is what? D1. Now, step 3 is what? D2. Step 3 is what? D2. It is having also a formula. Leave it. I'll come back to that one later. Now, how many steps are over? 3 steps. What's the first step here? Ln of S by X. D1, D2. D1, D2 are two numbers. They are what? Two numbers. We can see the normal table value of a number. Never go. We did it in the capital budgeting also or not. So for a number, say 2, a number I can see the normal table value or not, like that. Now step 4 is normal table value of D1. I call as NTD1. Step 5 is what? Normal table value of D2. I call as what? NTD2. How many steps are over? 5 steps. Step 1 is what? Ln of S by L. Step 2 is D1. Step 3 is D2. Step 4 is what? NTD1. Normal table value of D1. Step 6 is what? Step 5 is NTD2. Everybody is on home. Now, step 6 is ND1. Step 6 is what? ND1. 0.5 plus or minus NTD1. We already saw the normal distribution table that we add a normal table value to 0.5 or what? Subtract it based on the shaded area. Remember? That you remember or not capital budgeting? So normal table value should be added or subtracted from 0.5. So ND1 is 0.5 plus or minus NTD1. ND2 is what? 0.5 plus or minus NTD2. Step 7 over. Step 8 is present value factor e power minus TRF. So how many steps are over? 8 steps. First step is what? Ln of S by N. Second step is what? D1. Third step is what? D2. Next is what? Normal table value of D1. Normal table value of D2. ND1. What is ND1? 0.5 plus or minus NTD1. ND2. 0.5 plus or minus NTD2. Yes or no? Now. And step is what? E power minus TRF. Now. Step 9 is value of the call. We have all the numbers to find out the call value. Tell me what is the value of the call formula? S into ND1 minus X into e power minus TRF into ND2. S will be given in the question spot price. Kadaba? Now, ND1 we have found out or not? Yes. We found out ND1 in step 6. Kadaba? And X will be given in what? Question. E power T minus TR found out in what? Step number 8. ND2 found out in what? Step number 7. All the numbers are to find out the call option value is step number 9. Respond. Yes or no? Step 10 is N minus D1. Step 10 is what? N minus D1. Nothing but 1 minus ND1. Reverse probability. 1 minus Normal table always gives you what? Probability. So 1 minus n d1. Chip 11 is what? N minus d2. What? N minus a d2, 1 minus n d2. Step 12 is what? Value of put option. What is the value of the put option? Yes, x into e power minus tr of into n minus d2 minus s into n minus d1 is the value as well put option. Yes or no? Now, that's the one should go for the option value using what model? Black-Scholes model. Can I proceed now? Please tell me, how many steps are there in Black-Scholes model? 12 steps. Name the 12 steps. First step is what? Ln of s by x, d1, d2, nt d1, nt d2, nd1, nd2, e power minus tr of value of the call, n minus d1, n minus d2, value of the put option. In between, tell me, what is nd1? 0.5 plus or minus nd d1. What is nd2? 0.5 plus or minus nt d2. What is the value of the coin? S into nd1 minus x into e power minus tr into what is the value of the put option? S into n x in, okay, x into e power minus tr of into n minus d2 minus s into n minus d1. What is n minus d1? 1 minus n d1. What is n minus d2? 1 minus n d2. Now, everything understood here. Everything not understood, everything what? By heart. Okay. Only thing you have to by heart the formula for what? D1 and then what? D2. Just by heart it quickly. That's all. You have cornered, na? Just. This is the heart of the entire model, the calculation of what? D1 and D2. Okay, now. By heart, it. Over. What you are doing? Wait. First by heart, then switch off the AC. Okay, now. Okay, tell me. D1, all of what is D1? Ln of S by X plus sigma squared by 2 plus R of into T whole divided by sigma into square root of T. Be careful. So it is sigma squared by 2. It is one term plus what? R of. This number only should be multiplied by what? T. Now the full numerator. Everybody following on? So sigma squared by 2 plus R of into T all divided by sigma into square root of D. D2 is very simple. D2 is D1 minus denominator of D1. What is D2? D1 minus denominator of D1. What is denominator of D1? Sigma into square root of T. That gives the value of D2. With this, we have by heart that the steps for doing an option valuation using what model? Black-Scholes model. Can I start doing a problem or not? No. So, don't think that I am not allowing you to copy the step because when I do the problem, the step will be applied. Yes or no? No. At that time, we can have the number as well as what steps simultaneously. We can straight away start doing a problem in the Black-Scholes model. Now, please. I am just trying to save some time in unnecessarily avoiding some repeated things. We have a lot of discussion to make in the derivative segment further, like swaps, etc. That's why I'm just cutting short some discussion or copying time. Can we start or not? Now, please. Okay. Okay. Before I start, we are valuing the option using what model? Black-Scholes model. Now, Black-Scholes model uses all the five input factors. It has what all the five input factors. What are five factors? Spot price, strike price, interest rate, term, and then what? Volatility. If you see, all these five are there in this 12 step because the volatility comes in the D1 calculation. Sigma into square root of T, numerator sigma squared by what? 2. It comes in what? The D1 and D2 calculation. Spot price and strike price comes in what? Ln of S by X calculation. Yes or no? It also comes in what? The call value and put value formula itself straight away. term is obviously that when I calculate e power minus tr of the term also consider, also the interest rate is considered. D1 also considers the term as well as the interest rates. All the five are considered in this Black-Scholes option valuation model. Okay, now we will do one sum in the Black-Scholes model. Okay. Take question number 26. Before that, 25 is nothing but a two period binomial model problem. I give the problem as homework. Okay. Now, I'll give the solution as soon as I complete this particular sum. Okay. Now, no validation. So, let's take question number 26. Please. Shh. Stop talking. Find the values of call as well as put for the following on the assumption that the options are European with no dividend during the period. What happens if it is having a dividend will be the next stage of discussion. What happens if it becomes an American option will be a further discussion in the future classes. Can I proceed? No. I have four questions, 1, 2, 3, and 4. I'll do only one remaining, please. This is given only for you for the practice sake, that's all. Okay, because I don't have any validation in doing the number substitution in the classroom here. It is not worth the time spending. Yes or no? We are going to do more Black-Scholes problems because when I go and discuss about currency option, that will be using what? A Black-Scholes once again. I'll use Black-Scholes in capital budgeting, real option one, oil well, expansion model limit, doing what? The Black-Scholes. And we are not going to start in even interest rate option will be using the Black-Scholes. Now that I'll do only one Black-Scholes, but the preliminary problem I'll do only one sum. The remaining three, I give it as what? Homework. For you to have a practice of solving it. In a procedure, I'll give you the solution. And you need not even depend on me for solution. In the net, if you put all the five, if you go any website and type Black-Scholes calculator, a calculator will come, ask you all the five data, spot price, strike price, volatility, term, and then what? The interest rate. Once you click enter, it gives you what? Option value. It will ask call option or put option. Type enter, will be getting what? The option value. These are all available in the net itself. Even if I don't give answer, no need to worry. Have the answer in what? Any website that gives you Black-Scholes calculation. Any of you, please. Why you clap? Please. Now, take question number one. Spot price 50, the sum is spot price 50. E means what? Exercise price, it is 49, or rate of interest 7, T is 200 days. Always T should be expressed in what? Year. How would express in years here? 200 by 365. Standard deviation is 0.3. All the five factors given, they ask you to find out the option value using what model? Black-Scholes model. Can we start or not? No. We'll do it together. Write down. Question number 26. Question number 26. Option valuation using Black-Scholes model. Option valuation using Black-Scholes model. Option valuation using Black-Scholes model. Shall we start that? No. Facts. Facts. Spot price is equal to 50. Spot price is equal to 50. Strike price is equal to 49. Strike price is equal to 49. Rate of interest. What the rate of interest? 7%. Rate of interest 7%. Term 200 days. Standard deviation 0.3. Standard deviation 0.3. Can you start or not? Now, write down. Step 1. Ln of S by X. Step 1, Ln of S by X. ln of s by x. What is part price? 50. What is the exercise price? 49. Okay. ln of 50 by 49. Natural log of 50 by 49. Ln of 50 by 49 is equal to, you all take the calculator, do it please. Ln of, what is 50 by 49? 1.0205. Everybody following up? Now, please, what to do is go to the workbook last page. I have given you the natural log table and E table together. I just given it what? Together. I want 1.02. I want natural log of what? 1.02. Now, I think 1.02 comes in the next page. It comes in what? Next page. I don't have 0.5, that mean difference not available. Round it off, 1.02. Tell me, what is ln of 1.02? What is the number? 0.0198. We get the number 0.0198. I think you are all following or not? Now, so the number which I want to find out is x value is what? 1.02. ln of that number is what? 0.0198. Okay, everybody, yes or no? Now, that's what we find out, which is equal to, please write in the main table, which is equal to what? 0.0198. ln of s by x is 0.0198. Can we proceed or not? Next. Step 2, D1. Step 2, D1. Underline that. Step 1, have you all finished copying up? Yes or no?
Yes,
those who are not copied, step 1, raise your hand. Okay, copy step 1 quickly. Ln of s by x, 50 by 49. Ln of 1.0205, 0.0198. Shall I proceed? Now, step 2. D1. Step 2 is D1. Okay. Tell the formula, I'll put on the slide. What is D1? Tell the formula. Ln of s by x plus sigma squared by 2 plus r of into t whole divided by sigma into square root of t. Copy the formula. D1 is equal to, please copy the formula. D1 is equal to ln of s by x plus, D1 is equal to ln of s by x plus, ln of s by x plus sigma squared by 2 plus r of ln of s by x plus sigma squared by 2 plus r of into t whole divided by sigma into square root of t whole divided by sigma into square root of t sigma into square root of t. Can we substitute the numbers or not? Have you finished copying it? Now, all of you tell and write. What is ln of s by x? Tell me what it is. 0.0198 plus. 0.0198 plus. What is standard deviation squared? 0.3 squared divided by 2 plus 0.3 squared divided by 2. Substitute, apply and substitute 0.3 squared divided by 2 plus what is the risk-free rate? 0.07. 0.3 squared by 2 plus 0.07 into t should be always in years. 200 days, how many years here? 200 by 365 years. 200 by 365 years. Whole divided by sigma into, what is sigma we have? 0.3 into square root of, please tell me square root of 200 by 365. 0.3 into square root of 200 by 365. Now, please, just for you to get a familiarity, what is 0.0198? Tell me everybody. Ln of s by x. What 0.3 squared? Sigma squared by 2. Plus what is 0.07? What is 0.07? R. What is 200 by 365? T. What is 0.3? Sigma. What is square root of 200 by 365? Square root of T. If I simplify, I'll be getting 0.3729. I'll be getting 0.3729. D1 value is 0.3729. D1 is equal to 0.3729. Everybody respond, yes or no? Now, next is what? D2. What is D2? D1 minus 0.3 into square root of 200 minus 200 by 365. Yes or no? D1 minus denominator of D1. Any approach? Now, next is step 3, D2. D2 is equal to D1 minus sigma into square root of T. D1 minus sigma into square root of T, which is equal to, what is D1 tell me? 0.3729 minus, please write it, 0.3729 minus, 0.3729 minus 0.3 into square root of 200 by 365. 0.3729 minus 0.3 into square root of 200 by 365. 0.3 into square root of 200 by 365. Everybody understanding it or not? Now, if I simplify, I'll be getting 0.3729 minus 0.3729 minus 0.221. 0.3729 minus 0.221. 0.3729 minus 0.221 is equal to how much? 0.1508 is equal to 0.1508. 0.1508. Enappa respond, yes or no? Now, we have found out D1 as well as what? D2. Now, next step is to find out what? NTD1 and then what? NTD2. Now, first of all, up to this, those have not copied, raise your hand. Now finish copying, can I proceed? Now, next is, tell me what is D1 value? 0.3729. Next, step 4, NTD1. Step 4 is NTD1, unlike that. NTD1 means what? Normal table value of D1. Why don't NTD1 means normal table value of D1. NTD1 means normal table value of D1. Normal table value of D1. Now, please tell me what is D1? 0.3729. Please go to our workbook last page. Take the workbook last page. They given area under normal curve. Enappa right or not? Now, in that case, what is D1? 0.3729. Okay. I don't have 4 decimals at the table. Suppose only what? 2 decimals. Round off to 2 decimals and search. Okay. 0.3729. Can we round off to 0.37? Now, tell me what is 0.37? This is 0.3 and this is what? 0.37. How much is 0.1443? Able to locate the number or not? Now, 0.3729. Round off to 2 decimals. 0.37. What is 0.37? 0.3. Against at what? 7. What is the number? 0.1443. Now, write down. NTD1 is equal to NTD1 is equal to 0.1443. Everybody respond, yes or no? Now, step 4 or step 5? Step 5. NTD2. Step 5, NTD2. Step 5 is NTD2. NTD2 means, write down, NTD2 means what? Normal table value of D2. NTD2 means normal table value of D2. Normal table value of D2. Can I proceed up? Now, please tell me what is D2 we are having. Tell me the number of D2. What is the D2 number? What is the number? 0.1508. So I have to search against what? 0.15. Round up to 0.15. 0.1. And then what? 5. What is 0.15? 0.0596. So write down. NTD2 is equal to 0.0596. NTD2 is equal to 0.0596. NTD2 is equal to 0.0596. I hope everybody following or not. Now, how many steps are over? 5 steps. The next step, step number 6 is what? ND1. Step 6 is ND1. Step 6 is ND1. Now, listen here. First tell me, what is the formula for ND1? 0.5 ± NTD1. You ask plus or minus. Question arises now. Very simple. D1 number we got now. We got a D1 number or not? Tell me the D1 number which we calculated 0.3729 is plus 0.3729 or minus or plus. If the D1 value is plus, NTD1 should be added to what? 0.5. If the D1 value is what? Minus. The NTD1 should be minus to what? From 0.5. Yes or no? Same way, how to apply for what? D2 also. And the D1 values can even be negative. It all depends on the ln of S by X, which is a natural log table. Sometimes the values are negative also. Everybody following or not? No. So write on. Next. Step number 5 or 6? 6. ND1 is equal to, step 6, ND1 is equal to 0.5 plus or minus NTD1. ND1 is equal to 0.5 plus or minus NTD1. Which is equal to 0.5 plus, all of you tell me 0.5 plus what? 0.5 plus 0.1443 is equal to how much? 0.6443 is equal to 0.6443. 0.5 plus 0.1443 is equal to 0.6443. I hope everybody understanding it or not. Now write down note. If D1 is positive, add NTD1 to 0.5. If D1 is positive, add NTD1 to 0.5. If D1 is positive, add NTD1 to 0.5. And if D1 is negative, subtract it from 0.5. And if D1 is negative, subtract NTD1 from 0.5. If D1 is negative, subtract NTD1 from 0.5. Now why we added, tell me, in this problem? Positive. Hence we added. Can I proceed? Now, step 7. Step 7 is what? ND2. Step 7, ND2. Step 7, ND2. What is ND2? 0.5 plus or minus NTD2. ND2 is equal to 0.5 plus or minus NTD2. ND2 is equal to 0.5 plus or minus NTD2. Enappa, can I proceed on? No. Please tell me it is 0.5 plus or minus or plus. 0.5 plus 0.0596. 0.5 plus 0.0596. 0.5 plus 0.0596 is equal to 0.5596 is equal to 0.5596. Purinjadha? Now ND2 over. Next, step number 8 is what? E power minus TRF. Present value factor should be known or not? E power minus TRF. E power minus TRF. It is E power minus, what is risk free rate? 0.07. Into T should be in years now, 200/365. E power minus TRF, E power minus 0.07 into 200/365. We already know how to calculate this number. E compounding or D discounting, yes or no? Yes, E power minus 0.038. E power minus 0.038. 0.07 into 200/365 gives you 0.038. Put it up, E power minus 0.038. I think you can believe me, my calculation is on. We know how to find out E power. Tell me how to find out E power 0.038. Solupa. 1 plus 0.038 by 1 plus 0.038 squared by 2 plus 0.038 cubed by 6 and so on. So can I write the percent value factor straight away? So it is 1/1.0387. 1/1.0387. A rounding off has been done. 1/1.0387. 1/1.0387 is equal to 0.9627. 1/1.0387. 0.9627. 0.9627. 0.9627. Okay. Now, all items ready. Adapa. Now we can find out what value of the call option. Step 8 or step 9 or step 9. Value of call option. Step 9, value of call option. Step 9, value of call option. Tell me, what is the value of call option? Value of call is equal to VC is equal to, write the formula, S into ND1 minus S into ND1 minus X into e power minus TRF into ND2. S into ND1 minus X into e power minus TRF into ND2. S into ND1 minus X into e power minus TRF into ND2. Can I substitute the numbers or not? Now, tell me what is S? எல்லாம் சொல்லுப்பா சார், வாட் நம்பர் எஸ் இஸ் வாட் 50. கா சப்ஸ்டியூட் பை லுக்கிங் அட் த நோட் புக், 50 into வாட் இஸ் ND1? 0.6443 கடப்பா, 50 into 0.6443 மைனஸ் வாட் இஸ் எக்ஸ்? 49. எக்ஸ் இஸ் 49. வாட் இஸ் இ பவர் மைனஸ் டிஆர்எஃப்? 0.9627. 49 into 0.9627 இன்ட்டு வாட் இஸ் ND2? 0.5596. 49 into 0.9627 into 0.5596. I hope everybody understanding it or not. Now, if I simplify, I'll get 5.82. I got 5.82. What is 5.82? That is a premium. That is a fair premium for this particular option. For this particular option. So Black-Scholes helps you to value what? The call premium. How to find out a share price here? We have the D1 by KE minus E, Modigliani Miller formula and so on. Rather than like that, Black-Scholes has given a formula to value what? Call. Now, tell me, for this call option, with a strike price of what? 50. With a spot price of 50. Strike price of what? 49. Interest of? 7%. And then what? Term of how much percent? Term of how many years? That is 200 days. And a volatility of? 0.3. What should be the call value? 5.82. Now, everybody should value the same number in option contract? No. Because in this, the volatility number is anybody's choice. You may have a different volatility, I may have a different volatility. Standard deviation need not be based on past prices. It can even be based on what? Future. We learned how to find a future standard deviation. Ascending probability, sigma p in the x minus x bar the whole square. You may have a different range of FSP is predicted. I may have a different range of what? FSP is predicted. I don't say that the call should be valued at what? 5.82. If this is your input data, then this should be what? The value of the call. You know what I'm saying? The model gives you a way of valuing it. They do not say what should be your input. You know, the input is what? Yours. Where the sigma is highly probabilistic, because how much the share price varies, it is a wild guess. You know what I'm saying? So there only the perception changes. Now, next is step 9 or step 10? Step 10. All of you following? Now, I want to hear all your voices. What is step 10? Step 10. Step 10. So what is step 10? N minus D1. N minus D1. Step 10 is N minus D1. Always confirm whether you are here or not. N minus D1. What is N minus D1? 1 minus N D1. N minus D1 is equal to 1 minus ND1. 1 minus ND1. Which is equal to, please tell me, which is equal to what? 1 minus 0.6443. 1 minus 0.6443 is equal to 0.3557. Is equal to 0.3557. Is equal to 0.3557. 0.3557. Can I proceed or not? No. Finish writing a step 11. What is step 11? N minus D2. Step 11, N minus D2. What is N minus D2? N minus D2 is equal to 1 minus ND2. N minus D2 is equal to 1 minus ND2, which is equal to 1 minus, please, what is ND2? 0.5596. 1 minus 0.5596 is equal to 0.4404. Is equal to 0.4404. I hope everybody understanding it or not. Now, the last step is to value what? Put option. Step 12 is value of put option. Step 12, value of put option. Step 12, value of put option. Write the formula and then substitute. What the formula for VP? VP is equal to X into e power minus TRF into N minus D2. x into e power minus tr of into n minus d2 minus s into n minus d1 minus s into n minus d1 minus s into n minus d1. Okay. Finish writing it or not? Now, tell me substitution, what is x? 49 into, solpa substitution, 49 into 0.9627 into 0.4404. 49 into 0.9627 into 0.4404 minus, please tell me minus what? 50 into 0.3557. Minus 50 into 0.3557. Minus 50 into 0.3557. What is the value of the put option? 2.99. Value of the put option is 2.99. Everybody following it or not? No. So, what is the value of the call? 5.82. What is the value of the put option? 2.99. This call and put option is on a different asset, same asset? Same asset. Having different strike price, same strike price, same price. Different maturity, same maturity, same maturity. Then the value should satisfy put call parity or not? We put this 2.99 and 5.87, what should be satisfied? Put call parity should be satisfied. If it's not satisfied? Answer wrong. Black holes should always want to satisfy. Yeah. They will never allow it. Any model should never allow arbitrage. And the model is wrong. Yes, arbitrage is not like mispricing. When arbitrage comes here, mispricing. Every model, whether it is binomial, risk neutralization, black holes, all option valuation model will satisfy and should satisfy what? Put call parity. If the answer does not satisfy, then what is wrong? Your calculation wrong, not the model wrong. The calculation is wrong. Deal with the calculation. Can I check the numbers or not? Write down, check. Write down, check. Please. Shh. Don't check. If we substitute, check right. If we substitute the option values, if we substitute the option values in the put call parity equation, if we substitute the option values in the put call parity equation, the parity will be satisfied. If we substitute the option values in the put call parity equation, the parity will be satisfied. The parity will be satisfied. The parity will be satisfied. Can I proceed or not? No. Tell me the equation, please. What the equation? Vc plus Pv of x is equal to what? Vp plus Vs. Vp plus Vs. Can I substitute the numbers or not? What is the value of the call? 5.82. 5.82 plus. What is strike price? 49? 49 into 0.9627. Enna pa right or not? Adha PV of X no? 49.9627 is equal to, what is the value of put? 2.99 plus what? 50. Okay. Now simplify. 5.82 plus, what is 49 into 0.9627? Edha numbers, what is the number here? 47.17 as a number? 47.17. 5.82 plus 47.17 is equal to what? 2.99 plus 50. Simply, what is the number here? 52.99 is equal to what? 52.99. So the calculation is tallied. So class of black souls, because after so much the put call parity is tallying, yes or no? Now it should always tally. That's the beauty of the model. Are you following or not? Now please, it is more workmanlike than conceptual. That is a great concept there, but we just discuss like a workmanlike model. That's what is required for the exam also. Please tell me how many steps are there to calculate the option values? 12 steps. All of you, please, one last time. First step is what? Ln of S by X. What is S? Spot price. What is X? Strike price. What is Ln? Natural log table value. In examination, the table values will be straight away given. We need not say search for that in the tables. Okay, please. Shh. So, Lupa, let's quickly tell. Step 2 is what? D1. Step 2 is what? D1. Step 3 is what?
D2.
Step 4 is?
NTD1.
Yeah, step 4 is what?
NTD1.
Step 4 is what?
NTD1.
Step 5 is what?
NTD2.
Step 6?
ND1.
Step 7?
ND2.
Step 8? E power minus TR. Step 9? Valley of God. Step 10?
N
minus D1. Step 11?
N minus D2.
Step 12? Valley of put option. Is or no? Now, D1 is equal to? That's only here. D1 is equal to 1. Ln of S by S plus sigma squared by 2 plus R into T whole divided by sigma into square root of T. You have to necessarily by heart, you can't take bit and all for exam. Right? Now, duration or formula, you remember? Okay, now. Options chapter stopped. Okay, let's go back. Old memories. Malarum nenevagal here. Okay, now tell me. Duration. We had a formula, na? Duration for a, what I say, a plane bond. Duration for a what? Plane bond. Duration is equal to what? And a formula is here. Okay, we can use all the formula. Now, please. Shh. This is wrong. Please. Shh. Stop talking first. Now only I said, good morning. Plane bond I said. So, what bond I said here? Plane bond. What is that is a big formula. What is plane bond duration? Zero group one bond, tell me duration. That's only all zero bond duration. It is maturity. Now, at least that should be by heart. What is the duration of a bond? 1 plus y by y minus 1 plus y plus t into c minus y plus c into 1 plus y power t minus 1 plus y. Don't clap. I'm going to pay that. It's all no. Now, please. Now, for that is how important for me. So, see, I need not remember. I have a slide. I'm not writing exam. You should have by heart and that. Then so many problems still no. It's all no. Now, please. Now, see. All this only makes you prepared here. Whatever done. That is why I'm shouting again and again. Now, this formula remembrance. How many concepts here? Convexity, bond valuation, convexity, immunization strategy, horizon analysis. Now, I am not threatening you. We have come long way. We have just handled so many complex chapters, bonds, portfolio theories, dividend policy, left and right, buyback, rights issue, how it affects NPV, Mardi-Glanik Miller derivation. Enappa nyamaruka? Now, it is not a joke. Then we discussed lot of capital budgeting, Hiller, Small, etc. Now we are in what? Options. Now, see, everything is not joke. Again, I can say everything is not joke. Volume is that. Subject is having what? Volume. We have discussed so much. It is about IFM, money market edge. Money market edge, euro rates, domestic rate, leading, lagging, you know, exposure netting, interest rate parity, covered interest arbitrage, currency arbitrage, IRPT, please. Now, see, all exam papers are easy, please. All problems are not difficult. I can say, now, again I say, what we do in classroom, what we do in what? Classroom. Very good grip if I have, exam will be very easy only. Because what happens is, all this we discuss now, we have only a hazy idea. We don't have a grip. We know it. We don't know with what grip. The grip will come only when you consolidate. You're not understanding that. I'm saying this from the beginning. Unless you consolidate what has been learned, will go. Yeah, it is like a open drain. Okay, when I put water into a drain, it also what? Drains out. It will not be staying. Now, you should be having a capacity to withstand what has been discussed. Now, I did not open a word about portfolio. Then everybody will be very angry with me. Now, discuss it. Sharp single index, that formula, sharp optimum portfolio. We had Markowitz, CAPM, APT. Please. I am not deviating, just 2 minutes I am spending just to bring everybody to reality. Now, please, shh. I asked a duration formula, na? Most of you, I don't know, all of you, I don't want to comment, okay, most of you forgot it. Yes, sir.
இது கிரிமினல் பா, இட் இஸ் கோயிங் டு வாண்ட் எ கிரிமினல், பிகாஸ் ஒன் சம்திங் இஸ் டன் இட் ஷட் நாட் பீ ஃபர்கட்டன். நீ புரிஞ்சனா? Nothing should be in the notebook, everything should be in the mind. Black Scholes demon should not be from henceforth be in the notebook. Yeah, if you lose the notebook, you should be able to write the formula. You know, understand that exam you are not be allowed to take the notebook. Yeah, so no, stop. Formula by hearting the easiest thing. I did not discuss about concept. Purunjama, I did not discuss about what concept of volatility, duration, derivation. Namai purunjama, so much I discuss not. I am not even going into what concept. I am only asking you what a formula. Formula me forgotten. What will happen to concept? Yeah, me fade memory. Let me not able to recollect. Then what happens is, I'll say, you will be having a fair by hearting of the notebook. Understand? இதெல்லாம் இருக்கு. லைக் திஸ் யூ ஹவ் டு டூ சம் ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் ப்ராப்ளம் வில் பி ஏபிள் டு பி வாட் டு இஃப் தே ஆஸ்க் யூ சம் ட்விஸ்டட் க்வெஸ்சன் வித் த ஒரிஜினல் டிஸ்கஷன். சப்போஸ் ஜூரிங் பாண்ட் இஃப் ஆஸ் எக்ஸாம் க்வெஸ்சன் பி ஆஸ்கிங் ஆன்சரிங் ஈவன் வாட் டஃபஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் பிகாஸ் யூ ஆர் இன்ஃபார்ம். புரிஞ்சப்பா, அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் யூ வாட் இன்ஃபார்ம். நவ் இஃப் யூ ஃபர்கெட் இட், யூல் பி அவுட் ஆஃப் ஃபார்ம். யூல் பி ஏபிள் டு கெட் அ லிட்டில் பிட் டச் ஒன்லி, நாட் த வெரி ஃபைன் டச். ஆர் யூ ஃபன் வாட் ஐ அம் சேயிங்? நான் சொல்றது புரிஞ்சப்பா? நான் tell me for whom I am telling all this. Na ipo ukana na I use the word frequently, anxiety. It is only what bigas, so much effort has been put from this side in telling all this. Bujaba evlo pa kadal irukku nu solana. We have not rushed through any chapter till now, correct? Nor I will rush any chapter later also, that is guaranteed always. We have not rushed through even small concept from time value of money, compounding, discounting. I taught you, kada, you first understand the value of the effort. Okay, understand that this is not sentimental. Fees you paid is no match generally for the value of effort given. Understand that what you are going to give me as value is only when you read it. Kudapa, and the happiness also comes only when a student answers question, a teacher is good. Yeah, student blank na I am bad. You know what I am saying? So because they are not able to answer, say SSR class attend, yeah, all of them fail SFM, then what happens to me? Shouting la, then it is insult to me. It's not insult to me, it is bad about me. That is why I am just what shouting, please prepare, please read. Like that every faculty will expect. Now understand that when you answer, there is a highest joy. And for that, what you should do, revise. In a class, the most irritating is whenever you go back to any old portion, all of you stare at me as if I am doing a mistake. That is not right. Will you all revise or not? From today, put a plan. From starting, revise from what? IFM onwards. Now, time too short for those writing the current examination. And you are all living in a paradise that last 1 month, all books I can take and revise. Yeah, ISKA is there. என்ன கதப்பா, காஸ்டிங், டிடி, ஐடிடி, அக்கௌண்ட்ஸ், எஸ்எஃப்எம், சோ மெனி சப்ஜெக்ட், ஹவு வி கேன் ரிவைஸ். யா ப்ளீஸ், ஐ எம் நாட் டிஸ்கரேஜிங் யூ. எனி டைம் கேன் பி யூட்டிலைஸ், பட் யூ ஷுட் பி யூட்டிலைஸ் நா. ஹேவ் வேக்அப் கால், ஹேவ் வாட் வேக்அப் கால், அண்ட் தென் ஸ்டார்ட் ப்ரிப்பேரிங். கேன் ஐ போ சீட் நா? ப்ளீஸ் டெல் மீ வாட் இஸ் டி ஒன் ஃபார்ம்லா? இப்போ நான் யூ ஃபர்காட்டன் டெல் மீ வாட் இஸ் டி, வாட் இஸ் டி ஒன்? டி ஒன் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு வாட்? எல்என் ஆஃப் எஸ் பை எக்ஸ் பிளஸ் சிக்மா ஸ்கொயர் பை டூ பிளஸ் ஆர் ஆர் into t whole divided by sigma into square root of t. Yes or no? Now what is d2? D1 minus sigma into square root of t. What is ntd1? Normal table value. What is ntd2? Normal table value. nd1 0.5 plus or minus ntd1. When should you plus? d1 positive. When should you minus? d1 negative. ntd2 also same, 0.5 plus or minus ntd2. E power minus f, you know what is value of the call? S into nd1 minus x into e power minus trf into nd2. What is value of the put option? X into e power minus trf into n minus d2 minus s into n minus d1. That is regarding that. And what is n minus d1? 1 minus nd1. What is n minus d2? 1 minus nd2. That's all we have discussed about the Black-Scholes model. More about this model we are seeing In the later areas, with dividend, I'll discuss American options, Black-Scholes will be discussed later. All the currency options, interest rate options, everywhere will be using this what Black-Scholes model. Don't they solve only one problem? Minimum 5 to 6 sums will be doing before we complete the chapter derivatives. I think you're all following or not? I don't want to waste one time in doing what one more problem. Any apurujira? No, please. Shh. See, you may ask, sir. In D1 formula, if you look at the D1 formula, it is all additions and multiplication, division. Gadaba. Yelana S by X plus what this number, etc. You may wonder, sir, how can we have a negative D1? Gadaba. If you look at this formula, how can we have what a negative D1? A question may arise in our mind. Any apurujira? I said, because when D1 is minus, you should subtract from what? 0.5. Plus means what? Add it to 0.5, etc. or not. Now, if you look at, have a say, glance at the formula, there's no chance the formula can have a negative number bigger and not subtracting any number. Every number is what? Added or multiplied or divided. There's no negative sign in the formula. So, no. How D1 can be negative? Question arises now. Okay. Number? Ill enough? Yes, by. That is why I just want to have only one small discussion before I leave this Black-Scholes. Now, for example, take point 4, take part 4. We have part 4 now. Now, what is S? 40. What is X? 45. What is 40 by 45? Tell me the number here. What is 40 by 45? Two decimals. What is 40 by 45? S by X. What is the number? Point? 0.89, can I just 0.89 or not? Now, look at the natural log table for 0.89. Look at the natural log table for what? 0.89. What is 0.89? Look at this. It is here now, 0.89, point, minus 0.11653. That means when it is less than 1, that is always a natural log table, less than 1 is what? Negative. After 1 becomes what? Positive. In the Pareto order. So, ln of S by X is having a chance of having what? A negative number. So, therefore, D1 can also become what? Negative. It all depends on the ln of S by X calculation. In the Pareto, you'll find out now. So, I'll allow you to do the remaining 3 sums in the Black-Scholes model as a Homer problem. Please try it. The formula will be by heart and that's the main use. Can I pass it or not? Now, please. Now, with this, we have completed up to question number 26. We are discussing the area option valuation. There is an area called as what? Option valuation. What do you discuss? Minimum value of call, minimum value of the put, maximum value of a call, maximum value of the put. Beyond that, what is the arbitrage available? Yes or no? Put call parity, absence, arbitrage, binomial, risk utilization, two-period binomial, Black-Scholes. This one has been discussed. Yes or no? All this will be repeated once again. We'll repeat our discussion when we have dividends. So the next stage is what? Discussion of option valuation and dividends on the underlying asset is going to be the second stage of discussion. Everybody following or not? Now, from now onwards, most of the things will be known to us except for a minor adjustment here and there. I cannot spend as long as time what I spent already till now in this particular chapter in the remaining parts. Can I put it or not? Now, we are going to build upon the base discussion which has been made with small tinkering here and there with dividends, American options, etc. Can I put it or not? Now, option valuation and dividends, please.